Propositional logic. In propositional logic, first of all, what is proposal? What is proposition and what is propositional logic? The proposition is, propositional logic is based on true or false. When you talk about bits or boolean, you'll say it as 1 or 0. So proposition is what? Proposition is what? A sentence, a mathematical statement that is either true or false, but not both. So whenever you say something, it may be invalid, it may be invalid. How to prove it? We have to have some arsenal with us to actually present something, first of all. If you are able to present, then only you are able to analyze that, verify that. How to construct things? How to construct these statements mathematically so that we are able to go on for the proofs, for analysis? Proposition. Proposition is what? As I just said, the basic building block of logic is nothing but propositions. Logic is everywhere. Logic is everywhere. Logic is in your mind. Logic is in your computer program. Logic is in your computer. Logic is in your mobile. Everywhere we have logic. So, there is propositions. What is proposition? It is just a sentence. It is a declarative sentence. That is, you are declaring a fact. A sentence is declaring a fact that it is either true or false, but not both. Either true or false, but not both. Washington DC is the capital of United States of America. This is true. So it is a proposition. Toronto is the capital of Canada. Is it false or true? It is false. But because it is false, so it is giving you false. So it is a proposition. 1 plus 1 is 2. It is true. So it is a proposition. 2 plus 2 is 3. This is false. Even though it is a false, this is false, it is a proposition. But what time is it? Means, what time are you talking about? Read this carefully. What should I read? How carefully I should read? X plus 1 equal to 2. What is X? X plus Y equal to Z. What is X? What is Y? What is Z? We don't know. So these are not propositions. They're not propositions. In fact, if you give value X and Y and Z, then it will become a proposition. We'll use the variable P, Q, R, S like this to make the variable. These are the propositional variable. Just let us we'll use. Propositional variable. And then what is this true or false? We call them as a truth value. If you have a proposition, you say it is true, then truth value is T. If you have a proposition, the truth value is false. So we say F, false proposition. So the area of logic that is going to deal with the proposition is known as propositional calculus or propositional logic. Systematically developed by whom? Greek philosopher Aristotle. 2300 years ago. Then came George Boole, English mathematician. In 1854, in the books of Laws of Thought, he proposed so many methods for it. So if you have one proposition, two proposition, three proposition, we can combine them. We can add them, we can multiply them, we can add them, we can multiply them, we can negate them. We can draw inferences from them. We call them as compound propositions. We'll use the logical operators. So let P be the proposition. We'll start with a negation, negative. So negation of P is denoted by not P. If P is proposition, not P is also a proposition, but it is the negative of this proposition. What we'll write? It is not the case that P. P, and we'll write, it is not the case. So this is P, this is not P. This is P, this is not P. That is, if sun rises in the east, then you say, it is the case, or it is not the case, that sun rises in the east. So it becomes not P. We have an example, Michael's PC run Linux. And English is involved everywhere. Michael's PCs run Linux, just for find the negation. It is not the case that Michael's PC run Linux. You can easily simply express it like this, Michael's PC does not run Linux. Vandana's smartphone has at least 32 GB of memory. How to find the negation? It is not the case. Just add, it is not the case here. Rest thing remains same. This negation can also be expressed like this. Vandana's smartphone does not have at least 32 GB of memory. Or you can also say, One in a smartphone has less than 32 GB of memory. All these are correct. These are negation. So negation means what? If P is true, this is called the truth table. Whenever you are presenting the all possible values of P in a column form or in the columns form or row or column form, it is the table which is called as the truth table because we are presenting the truth values. So true, negation of true is false. Negation of true is false. Negation of false is true. So true, not P, if P is T, not P is false. If P is false, not P is true. So when we add two or more proposition, we'll call them as connectives. This is the unary operator called as negation operator. Then we introduce AND or conjunction. Conjunction. What is conjunction or AND? If I say P and Q, so P and Q has to be together true to make this proposition true, otherwise always false. So P and Q, if they are propositions, then the conjunction of P and Q, which is denoted by P and Q, is the proposition P and Q. And the conjunction, this P and Q, is only true when P and Q are both true, otherwise it will always be false. Though both of these has to be true. True. P and Q has to be true to make this P and Q true. Otherwise it will be false. Right? Let us take an example. And Rebecca's PC has more than 16 GB free hard disk space. And Q, this is P. Now Q, the processor in Rebecca's PC runs faster than 1 GHz. The conjunction is, you just have to add a word AND. That is, Rebecca's PC has more than 16 GB free hard disk space and, you are adding AND, the processor in Rebecca's PC runs faster than 1 GB. So if you want this proposition to be true, both first one and second one has to be true. Otherwise, it will be false. Any of the condition goes false, or both of the condition goes false, both of the proposition are false, then the AND is false. Then we have disjunction. This is OR. This is called disjunction. What is the disjunction? What is the disjunction? Disjunction. P or Q means they both have to be false to make it false, otherwise always true. If P and Q are propositions, the disjunction of P and Q, which is denoted by P or Q, is the proposition P or Q. That is, this disjunction P or Q is false when both P and Q are false, otherwise it will always be true. See, P and Q is only true when both are true, otherwise always false. P or Q is only false when both are false, otherwise always true. This you have to remember. So, the OR which we have seen is inclusive OR. What it is? Inclusive OR. So, there is one other term which is exclusive OR. Exclusive OR. What is this? Let us take an example. Students who have taken calculus or computer science can take this class. That means either you have taken calculus or you have taken computer science or you have taken calculus or computer science. Because this is OR, it is always be true. This will only be false when you have not taken calculus and you have not taken computer science. But there is one more thing, exclusive OR. What is this exclusive OR? Students who have not taken calculus or computer science, but not both. See, either calculus or computer science. Calculus, let us write as calculus. Calculus or computer science, yes. But not both. This we have added. Can enroll in this class. This is exclusive OR. I'll give you one more example. Soup and salad comes with an entree. This entree is what? Restaurant means that customer can have either soup or salad. It doesn't say you can have both, but not both. This is exclusive OR. So this is OR, but exclusive OR is shown like this. It is simply x, y dash plus y, x dash, where y, x, this x and y are proposition, the dash are simply the negation. I show you first of all the OR, then I'll go back to the conditional statement. This is P or P XOR, we call it as XOR. So if both are true, then it will be false. Both are false, it will be false. Otherwise, if they both are different, then only it will be true. This is exclusive of. So, what is the disjunction of the proposition we have just seen in example 5? The disjunction of P or Q is nothing but the first sentence adding or with this. So, either this is true or this is true, both are true, it is always be true. But both are false, then only it is going to be false. Right? P or Q, but not both, is P XOR, a P XOR. And this is always only be true when both are different, otherwise it will always be false. Now we come to conditional statement. Conditional statement is of type if P, then Q. If P, then Q, this type. If P holds, Q holds. If P is true, Q is true. We say, okay, it is true. Because if P holds, Q holds. But if P holds and Q does not hold, it has to hold. So it is false. But if the P does not hold, anything can come here. So it will always be true. So P and Q, if they are propositions, the exclusive OR we have just seen is denoted by P or XOR Q, is the proposition that is true when exactly one of P and Q is true and is false otherwise, right? So we are dealing with now conditional statement. P implies Q. So P implies Q, this P implies Q, this is a conditional statement. This is a proposition. If P, then Q. So this conditional statement is false when P is true and Q is false. Otherwise it will always be true. It will always be true. This is only false when this P is true and Q is false. This P is called as the hypothesis, antecedent, premise. While this Q is called as conclusion, consequence. So this is implication. We call it as P implies Q also. Okay. Let us see the truth table. We have just seen the truth table. And we have seen just when one is true, P is true and Q is false, then only it will be false, otherwise always true. We can also write if P then Q, if P, Q, if P is sufficient for Q, Q if P, Q when P, sufficient or necessary condition for P is Q, Q unless not P, P implies Q, P only if Q, a sufficient condition for Q is P, Q whenever P, Q is necessary for P, Q follows from P, all these are this only. P implies Q. Now, if you have any kind of suspicion, I'll give an example. Say you have a politician. He says, if I am elected, I will lower the taxes. Okay, minus sign. I will lower the taxes. So, if I am elected, I will lower the tax. If this is true, this is true. Good. But if I am elected, but I don't lower the tax, that means I have cheated people. That means this is false. But if I am not elected, that means it is false. I may lower your taxes. Doesn't matter. If I lose, I may not lower your taxes. Doesn't matter. So this is the truth table. One more example I'll give you. If a professor is there, he says, if you get 100% in the final, then you get an A. So you get 100% and you are awarded A. This is P, this is Q, this is P, this is Q. All is fine. But if you get 100% but you don't get A, you feel cheated. That means this is false. If you don't even get 100%, there is no point of discussing this question. So, in this form, even if this is true or false, it doesn't matter. It will always be true. This is again your P implies Q. So, all these are P implies Q. There are discussions about P and P implies Q can be written in various forms. We have P as the statement Maria learns discrete mathematics. Q is the statement Maria will find a good job. You have to express P implies Q in English. So, P is this statement, Q is this statement. P implies Q simply means if Maria, you just have to add if and then. If Maria learns discrete mathematics, then she will find a good job. You can also write Maria will find a good job when she learns discrete mathematics. You can also go with for Maria to get a job, it is sufficient for her to learn discrete mathematics. Again, you can say Maria will find good job unless she does not learn discrete mathematics. Right? All these are conditional and they portray the same discussion, same value. But if Juan has a smartphone, 2 plus 3 equal to 5. How does this P and Q are related? This is the hypothesis, this is the conclusion. They are not related. Juan may have helicopter. How does it matter? 2 plus 3 will always be 5. If Juan has a train, it doesn't matter. 2 plus 3 is always false. So these two are not related. We'll always try that P and Q has to be in mathematics. We'll see the P and Q should be related. So we'll see like that. Okay, our reasoning should be if P then Q. Now, if P then Q is also used in programming. I'll just show you an example. If this is true, if it is true, then this will be executed. This line will be executed. If 2 plus 2 is 5, this line will not be executed. That is, in this condition, if 2 plus 2 is 4, this is really 4, this is true, this is proposition P and this is true, then this is going to be true. So X will be assigned X plus 1. If I assume X is 0 initially, so X will be assigned 0 plus 1, that is X will be having 1 value after completion of this. Converse, contrapositive and inverse. So what is converse? If you have P implies Q, then Q implies P is the converse. Right? If P implies Q, then not Q implies not P is the contrapositive. And not P implies not Q is the inverse. These are converse, contrapositive and inverse of the conditional statement. You see, this contrapositive and this P implies Q will have the same truth value. That is why we call them as equivalent. And the converse and inverse will have same truth values. They are equivalent. They are not equivalent to these two. Okay. This is the equivalency and we'll see an example. Don't worry about that. We have an example here. Write the contrapositive, the converse and inverse. We have just seen how to write contrapositive, converse and inverse. So the home team wins whenever it is raining. So P implies Q means if it is raining, then the home team wins. So P implies Q is like this. This is P, this implies Q. If it is raining, then the home team wins. What will be the contrapositive? Contrapositive will be if the home team wins, that is, if the home teams win, then it is, if the home team, this is contrapositive, I'm so sorry. If the home team does not win, then it is not raining. I hope you got the idea. Then, if the home team wins, it is raining. If it is not raining, then the home team does not win. If it is not raining, that is, this is not P implies not Q. As we just saw, that two are equivalent, two others are equivalent. That is, inverse and converse are equivalent. Contrapositive and the initial by this is conditional statement is they are equivalent. Now we come to biconditional. If you say P implies Q and if you also say Q implies P, if P then Q and if Q then P, then there are two arrows, one like this, one like this. We need to combine them. This is your biconditional. Biconditional, P and Q if they are proposition. The biconditional is the proposition. If P, then only and only if Q. P only if and only if Q. So this biconditional P implies, double implies Q is when P and Q have the same truth value. Otherwise, it will be false. P and Q, if they have the same truth value, it will be true. Otherwise, it will be false. Then that is true, true. True, false, false, true, otherwise false, right? True, 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 false, false, true, otherwise false. This is biconditional. So you can also write this B biconditional or double implication as P is necessary and sufficient for Q. If P, then Q, and conversely, you can also write P if and only if Q. So you can always write like this P. First, I just said P implies Q, then you add this with Q implies P. If you combine them, this is the condition, and this is nothing but the P double implies Q. You can take an example. If P is the statement you can take flight, Q is the statement you buy a ticket. Then P double implies Q is what? You can take the flight if and only if you buy a ticket. So this statement is true if P, this P and Q are either true, either both true or both false. That means if you buy a ticket, you can take a flight. And the second one is, when both are false, if you don't buy a ticket, you don't fly. Okay? Otherwise, all the conditions, the other condition should be you should get, you might have got some free trip or you have taken, but the airline might have, you know, barred you from going. Truth table of compound propositions. So we have already seen conjunction, disjunction, conditional statement, biconditional statement, that is this one, this one, this one, this and this, right? So we can now combine them. We can combine them, but in order to put the value, the best way is to show them in the tabular form. How to show them in tabular form? That is called as a truth table. So if you have P and the P or not Q implies P and Q. So if you want to prove it using the, you know, normal English language, that will be one method, but I'll show you another method. How? With the truth table. When I complete this, you'll be able to understand what this is saying. See, this is P, this is Q. So two variables, that means two square, four possible rows. Four possible rows. If R was being, you know, there, two cube, that means eight. Eight rows has to be there. But we have two. So true, false, true, false. True, true, false, false. If Q has been there, true, false, 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 false. Right? This eight rows will be there. First of all, P is there. Not Q is not there. So Q, take Q and negate it. True to false, false to true to false, and false to true. Then you just AND them and in OR them. Sorry. When you OR them, it will be only false when both are false. So we have one condition where these two are false. So it will be false. Otherwise, all will be true. This is met. Now let us take P and Q. P and Q means AND means. It will be always false. It will be false only when both are false. Right? Otherwise, always true. So both false. Then only false. Both false. This P and Q. Both false. P and Q. If both false, then only false. Otherwise, this one. Sorry. Both false. Then only false. See, this is AND. False and false will give you false. False and true will give you false. True and false will give you false. Both has to be true to make it true. But how we can take these two and now apply the condition? We know when we have true and false, then only it is going to be false, otherwise true. So see, we are combining this. True, true is true. True, false is false only. True, false is false only. But false, false is true. So this is your true, false, this is your truth table. Now, precedence of logical operators. You have seen this, you have seen this. If I say P or Q, which one will be taken first? This or this? We have a precedence order. First of all, negation will be taken, then AND, then OR, then implied, then double implied. This is the precedence, right? You have to follow these kind of precedence. If you don't want to follow, then you have to put a bracket, parenthesis. Now, logic and bit operations. What is bit? Bit is binary digit. A well-known statistician, John Tukey, introduced in 1946. Then Boolean, you know, Mr. Boole, Boolean algebra has come. So in Boolean algebra, also we take only two values, 0 and 1. Why not to combine our true and false with this? 0 we can say false, and 1 we can say true. So what the all tables we have seen, if we change 0 to in place of 0 or in place of false, we can put 0. In place of true, we can put 1. You can also do those things in logic and bit operations. How? See, we can do this. We say negation is not in Boolean. This is OR. This is AND. And implies, we'll see about implies. But we know these are basic games. One more is there, XOR. This is XOR. So what we have done here is, this is X or Y. x and y, x, x or y. All these were in previous tables, we have seen that it was true and false. Now we have just replaced the true with 1, the false with 0, and the result comes here. See, in x or y, it will be only 0 when both are zeros. In x and y, it will be only 1 when both are 1s. In x or y, if both are same, it will be 0. Otherwise, if they both are different, then only it will be 1. See, both are 1, it will be 0. Now, what is a bit string? Bit string means you can have 1 bit, 2 bit, 3 bit, 4 bit, 5 bit, 6 bit, 7 bit, 8 bit. Like this, you can have a bit string. So now you can perform the bitwise or bitwise AND. See, I'll show you an example. This is an example. You have 1 bit string, you have another bit string. Now you have to find bitwise OR. So you just take these two values first. What is OR of 0 and 1? 1. What is OR of this 1 and 0? 1. Similarly, AND, take any value. AND is only when both are true, then only it will be true. So see, 1 1 gives you 1. 1 1 gives you 1. So we are combining single bits. What is XOR? When both are same, it will be 0. See, both are same, it will be 0. Both are same, it will be 0. This is how we perform the bitwise OR and XOR.